All right. So a warm welcome to everybody in attendance this evening for our USA Baseball Homegrown event. We're excited to continue to connect USA Baseball national team alumni to their hometown communities while providing families and youth with the unique opportunity to get to know our national team alumni from their area. You see, Mychal Givens is with us. Quick moment. Let's recognize some of the families joining us this evening. Hillsborough County Public Schools, Pinellas County Schools, Manatee County School District, Big Brothers, Big Sisters of Tampa Bay, the City of Tampa Parks and Rec, the North Tampa Athletic Association, the Florida District Six Little Leagues, and all other RBI and youth leagues in attendance this evening. And Mychal, I'm Darren Vaught, by the way. Mychal Givens is with us, a pro team, World Baseball Classic champion with Team USA, 18U team alum, 16U team alum, and Major League pitcher, star USA Baseball national team alum of ours, Mychal Givens. And then Michaela there, right, as well.
Two little girls that run around in the room. You might hear them a little bit.
Before we get into some questions, because we've got our attendees sent a list of them, Mychal, just encourage those who, you mean, maybe your youth player, your youth athlete is watching, sitting at home in front of a computer screen, feel free to take a photo and tag us in those and post them to social media as well. Mychal, I mean, your hometown, the Tampa Bay area, start by just describing what it was like for you as a child, as a young football player, a young athlete, and a young student.
I've been lucky and fortunate. My parents found a way to give birth to me in Tampa, Florida, because it's a really great MLB history here with a lot of greats like Wade Boggs. He was an alumni of my high school. Hudek, and furthermore, like Luis Gonzalez, Mark. There's so many. Gary Sheffield, Dwight Gooden, Carol Everett, Derek Bell, Luis Gonzalez. It's so many great athletes that came out of Tampa. And unfortunately for me, I got lucky to have the opportunity to be around like Gary Sheffield, Fred McGriff, and those guys growing up as a kid and get the experience and learn their knowledge and teach me as a kid, young mind, to get where I'm at.
Nice. Well, I've got some questions that I think would be appropriate. We'll mix them in with these Hindi questions. And I'll start with number one. Mychal, it's when did you know that you wanted to play baseball? That's from the Stanton Schneider family there in the Tampa area.
Pretty much the day I picked up a baseball, and I was influenced by my great-grandfather. He's from Puerto Rico. He was a big influence to me and taught me the old school feel of Jackie Robinson, the old school feel of Roberto Clemente. Those are my biggest idols. I always love and appreciate when we celebrate Jackie Robinson Day and Jackie Robinson and Roberto Clemente. So, but first, I started at 3 years old. I was just loved and committed to just being in the community with my friends and loving the game.
And obviously, at 3 years old, you can dream of being a major leaguer if you're aware of the landscape and how things work. At what point did it become clear to you that, you know, maybe, you know, with the right mindset, the hard work, and some lucky breaks here and there, when did it become clear, you know, I'm going to gun for a career in the major league?
It started, like, again, as a kid. You always have that question, what do you want to do when you grow up? And always stuck to me, I want to be a Major League Baseball player. Seeing it with my great-grandfather, seeing him loving the back in the Florida Marlins, not the Miami Marlins at the day. So that was his favorite team growing up, and it just inspired me. Like, I wanted to do that. It looks fun. It's a great team chemistry. And when I got to high school and got a lot of the letter content of colleges and opportunity during my junior to go into my senior year, that I had a possibility to be drafted in the higher rounds. And I just always had a mindset as a young kid. But when it came to the fact of the draft, and I was like, this is it. And I always stuck to it I wanted to be a major league player.
This next question is from the Dixon family of the Inter Bay Little League in Tampa. What other sports did you play growing up that may have helped you along the way? You know, whether it was, you know, becoming more athletic or things like that, things that helped you become a baseball player? What other sports propelled you?
Yeah, I played a lot of different sports in middle school, running track and playing soccer, playing basketball, playing flag football. Then when I got to high school, kind of limited to basketball and baseball, but like using all those sports and seeing these kids now, I feel like they need to continue to be a multiple sport athlete. Because again, you don't hear, I like to hear the Bo Jackson. I like to hear the Deion Sanders.
With you mentioned flag football. With that in mind, a Tampa-centric question. Are you a Bucs fan? I assume that you're rooting for them in the Super Bowl?
Sad to say, I am. I could say essentially a Bucs fan from being in Tampa, but I'm just a big Tom Brady fan. I was a Patriot fan since I was in middle school, a Gronk fan. But like to say it, I've always supported my hometown. I'm a big community guy, and I love everything about it and everything going forward. So I'm rooting for them definitely for Sunday and going forward.
Nice. Very good. This one comes from the Riggins family there in Tampa. Who were your favorite baseball players or other athletes growing up?
Number one for sure is Ken Griffey Jr. He was my idol. I loved him to death to what he's done in his career. And to have that opportunity to play with your dad is like, it just amazed me and is always inspired. The love that they both had and the bond they had. Ken Griffey Jr. was my number one player. And for like, I had Bo Jackson and other ones. I got to meet Ozzie Smith and Jackie Robinson. I got to meet his daughter and stuff like that. But Ken Griffey is my number one and always been.
Now, I know you were a two-way star, especially in your youth and in high school. And in fact, when you joined the Orioles, it was sort of presumed that you were going to be a shortstop of the future, right? And so you had some skills hitting. Did you find yourself, did you try to emulate Griffey at all? Did you have like a little waggle in your stance?
I can remember like it was yesterday. I was 8 years old. I went to a library looking up more books on Ken Griffey Jr. And they had a video of his stance and everything. Like a little teaching and little league video of Ken Griffey. And I imitated him all the way, and just the grind he went through and the love of the game he had.
Yeah. What do you remember most about your days playing at HB Plant High, and what from that time inspired you most?
Playing with my kid, all my guys, my friends I grew up with since I was in middle school and elementary, and we all grew up together and went to high school together. That inspired me and being with them and being such a community South Tampa kid and a Tampa kid itself just inspired me to try to win state championship with my guys, my friends. And that was the biggest important thing to me, just the bond and the chemistry with my teammates.
This next one comes from the Gilliam family in St. Petersburg. What was your biggest challenge on your path to being a professional baseball player, and how did you overcome it?
The biggest grind playing all those games, from going to high school, playing other few games, but like with me, it was playing 30 games here and then take a break and play another few games. But straight into minor leagues and playing 142 games, it was a big adjustment. It was a grind getting on buses, going to road trip for 15 hours. It was a grind, but I overcame that from a lot of experience throughout the grind and how baseball is, it's a game of failure. So I had to go through a lot of failing and to understand what I need to do to be a baseball player.
I like this one. This is from the Montero family. They say, we know the catcher gives signs to the pitcher on a regular basis, but does the pitcher ever give signs to the catcher? How do you communicate to your battery mate?
There's some guy, I don't really do give signs or anything back to the catcher. There's people that like wipe their shirt or give signals to repeat a pitch or change location on that, or they don't have to keep on shaking and stuff like that. But that's the only thing I can say, like giving signs back to the catcher.
What was the hardest lesson you learned while playing, or what has been? That's from the Neander family. What has been the hardest lesson you've learned while playing?
I think that's a great question. to accept failure. I think these kids don't accept failure, and these parents is always constantly going to lessons and want to be successful, and everybody wants to be successful. But accepting the failure of the game is the biggest, I think, life lesson skill that I had to deal with, and I think everybody has to deal with, because it's a grind, and you have to accept to fail to understand how to succeed.
This comes from the LaBarge family in Palm Harbor. Who's the toughest hitter you've ever faced?
None of them. I can't exclude that. They're major league baseball players for a reason. They're all tough, but at the same time, I do take my stuff over a lot of people, and I have the confidence in saying I can get every hitter out. But at the same time, they're a big league hitter for a reason. But at the same time, I do take my stuff over a lot of their stuff.
All right, well, maybe there's a different way to frame that, and I'll sort of rework it to say, all right, you imagine, or hypothetically, Mychal, you strike out the opposing batter. Who is it that's going to make you the most jacked up?
Hitters that those pesky hitters that want to go for a single instead of for a home run, I could say. That just try to grind out bats, foul after foul, just trying to just get a little single instead of trying to go for the double or home run.
Yeah, that's good. This is a fun one from the Allen family. Mychal, if you could be any superhero, which one would you choose?
Oh, I love that. I love it. Not a baseball. What's his name? Professor Xavier, Professor X.
Okay.
I can read minds.
Yeah. Okay. I didn't expect that. I've heard that you're big into the Flash too. Would he be like in that pecking order somewhere?
Well, that was two different comic books and all that. I was really quick and fast growing up. I stole a lot of bases, and I used that as my email since I was a kid. Whenever I started to have an email, using the word Flash. I love Flash and being fast and quick and to being in two different areas and not to be seen.
Yeah, no, and especially given time and experience, you realize that the mind control and the mind reading, that's way more valuable, actually, probably. from the Cook family, what advice can you give to a young ball player that's trying to concentrate and or recover mentally while on the mound? So this is about mental toughness. What advice would you give to a youngster?
Definitely, like on the mental mound, like at the young kid, like they need to accept the failure and just learn how to throw a ball over the plate first. Just throw strikes and have fun. You're going to give up your home runs. You're going to give up your hits. And I think, like, I have my foundation, my team I have is to just throw the ball over the plate. And if what happens, that's not in your control. Your control is to do what is those strikes. So mentally, just stay focused and throwing strikes. And you have a lot of years of baseball to grind out, to understand pitching it. But to throw strikes is the biggest mental point for a kid to get.
This comes from the Brina family. What's the fastest ball you've ever thrown?
Topped out at 100. My first time topping out at 100 is 2015. Against the New York Yankees or the Trenton Yankees in AA.
Okay. Did you know that you had reached like a personal best?
Not really. What the guys in the minor leagues, you have the starter pitcher takes the velocity behind home plate, and he's the one that told me. And because a lot of the mile per hour at stadiums could be up, like he'd be off by a few or something like that. But the guy that took my radar gun that day told me right after the game.
So you throughout your life too, though, have probably hit like a personal best velocity multiple times, right? Like you probably remember being a kid at maybe 16, 17 years old and thinking, oh, that's the hardest I ever threw that ball. At when you throw one 100, do you feel that? Like, did you think when you grooved it in there, okay, that's got a chance to be the fastest ball I've ever thrown? Is that something you ever think about?
No, I never thought of ever hit 100, and I actually had a bet on my coach because the arm slot, how I threw, he's like, oh, you never be able to throw 100. But I always threw hard as a kid and threw hard as a high school, but he always doubted. He always believed in me, but he doubted me I could hit 100, but I proved him wrong.
And this last one here from the Houks family in Tarpon Springs. What helped you to stay focused and keep going when obstacles got in your way? And I think you've sort of touched on this, but you know, what helped stay focused and keep going when obstacles got in your way?
Pretty much just a support group of my parents and my great grandparents, and they the one raised me. That was a really helped me through a lot of things, and having the support of my team, my community, even as a kid and to being a major league player now. Having a support group and understand, like, for these kids to, they don't have to win right now. It's not the winning now. It's just winning where we get to the big leagues. That's still when you're trying to say you accomplish everything you have. And not going 4-for-4 for a game, going 0-for-4, getting guys in, all the little things that can overcome and make you mentally get through a lot of things.
Tell me about Mychal, the non-athlete. What did you do growing up in that area as a kid that might not have involved baseball or any other sport?
Just being Mychal Givens, the community person, I loved my family, I loved my friends, and loved my coaching staff, loved everything about them. Just the support group and all the people around them to help me to be who I am, who I became, and being such a aspect of my community. And now to be coaching little kids, I've been doing it for 13 years and loving the kids, seeing them grow and wanting to see them grow as like I did.
And talk to me about the applications of your playing sports, right? And the lessons learned there and how you can apply those for the attendees watching, the youth attendees. How you were able to apply those in settings like a classroom, right? Because there's some similarities when you're
yeah,
adversity and things like that.
I'll do school first, just preparing and like how you prepare for a test and how the mentally approach to have something prepared in your head. And that's what helped too. Like a lot of teachers, even my ones I adore, tell me like, you're going to be a great baseball player, but you have to learn how to prepare and to prepare it in school and to prepare it in the world in life and prepare it in baseball helped me a lot to get through a lot of things like that. And, what was the question?
Yeah, no, that was it. Because that, like I said, I was asking you to compare the two, because I think, you know, as a kid, we probably have a tendency to view the two as separate things, right? When there are a lot of similarities, when overcoming adversity on an athletic playing field and also maybe in a classroom, because at times it gets tough in both avenues.
Yeah, and that's like the best to say, like in classrooms, like how you prepare for a test and or SATs, you literally study, study, study. And same thing, people think we just wake up out of bed as major league players and go pitch against the greats. But no, like I had to learn about Darren O'Day, Zach Britton, Brad Brock, Brian Mattis, like how to prepare every day, have a routine, how to study the hitters, what do you see, what. And it's so much goes into it. And now to call a veteran is kind of to get there. It's fun. It's been cool and fun. But every day sitting in the, being a lab rat, and people used to make jokes about that, but it's real. And to be in there to study hitters, and because they have the studies on you every single day. So you have to play a little chess game.
Yeah. You know, it's not like you just wake up and are suddenly able to throw 100 miles per hour, right? I mean, there was a lot that happened before that throw that went into it. And it's a lot of work and preparation, as you said. Tell me, you mentioned your community involvement. Tell me about the Givens Back Foundation, something I know you're proud of, and you guys do a lot there in the area.
Yeah, I always thought as a kid, my last name will hopefully mean something until I got to the big leagues. Then I was doing so much with the youth, coaching kids, and I told my agent, he's been to help with this. And I said, I want to give back to my community. And I was like, what's the name should be? And we were like thinking so hard, and it just popped in the head. It's like, just use your last name, give us back. And when we started the last 5 years, and I just wanted to give back because it starts with the kids first. And if we didn't have to get these kids to the right direction, to be really, really respectful of the game, leadership, and good sportsmanship, I wanted to give back to them and my community. And teaching these kids is, we're more than baseball with our foundation. We're a family. And we do a lot of things as far as we give back to the community during Thanksgiving, passing out turkeys, teaming up with the Tampa Police Department, trying to build that connection with the police department in the neighborhood. And we team up with the city of Tampa. Each one of my kids and their parents, we all go as a team, and we go shopping for a kid on a piece of paper that's given by the city, a list. And we go shopping and meet them in person and kind of be really hands-on and face-to-face with them. So a lot of that meant really more to me, my name, last name, what people did for me to get where I'm at. And I'd to continue doing my community and love them, what they've done for me.
That's really good stuff. I encourage anybody who's not aware of it, check out the Givens Back Foundation. Mychal, what's a piece of advice that you have received in your life that you would relay to a group of young athletes, young students, such as those watching today?
Don't give up, but at the same time, like, people miss to have fun. I think that's the little simple thing of that. Never give up, but have fun. Like, people, they take this as parents sometimes try to think it's a job, and it's like we have to be successful. But we miss a lot of the things, like playing backyard baseball and just having the time in your lives of memories and not chasing trophies, chase the memories. And I think that's the biggest thing I can say.
Nice. Anything else you'd like to say to the kids from your hometown while we've got an audience here?
Nah, the kids in my hometown, let's keep the great tradition of Major League Baseball players that we've been having, that we had the last few years. And I have to give a shout out to HB Plan and Dennis Braun. He pushed us, and we have 7 big leaguers in the last 13 years. And that's impressive of stat that people don't realize. We haven't won state championship, but we definitely grew a lot of big leaguers. And just keep going forward and just having fun and grinding out and be you and have fun and be respectful for your teammates.
No, that's all good stuff. And I will say, just based on, you know, what I know about Plant and the area at large, the countless names you started to mention when we started talking, for those watching, if you want to be a major leaguer, like, you're in a good spot to do that. You know, it's just be earnest and just work hard and that sort of thing, because the capability has been proven to be there, such as the case with Mychal here. And Mychal, man, we appreciate you for sure as a part of the USA Baseball family, as being part of that 2017 World Baseball Classic championship team. The trophy's around here somewhere. I'm at it's around here. Thankful for your contributions to, again, the organization, the baseball community as a whole, and really thankful for the time on this seminar tonight. So we hope this has provided families with a chance to get to know you, Mychal, from your community. And to all youth in attendance, we hope this goes to show that you too can accomplish anything that you set your mind to. To all the families interested in additional baseball or softball related tools and tips, and for information on how to register your child for a local league, we encourage you to visit playball.org, as well as usabdevelops.com. Again, it's playball.org for additional resources, as well as usabdevelops.com. Mike, good to catch up, man. Good to see
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Glad to see you're still able to knock out super dad duties while being a
dad
at the big league level.
I appreciate it, guys. I hope to see y'all soon.
Sounds good. That's Mychal Givens. Appreciate you, man. And we'll catch you again soon.